Hi, I'm Jillian Rogers, Director of Marketing Communications for Analytics at Wharton.
And I'm Jaden Dicopoulos, Data Scientist at AI and Analytics for Business at Wharton.
And today, Jane gave a remarkable workshop to our students about ChatGPT and using it to create business solutions. So I thought, what better way to cover Jane's workshop on ChatGPT than to let ChatGPT do it for me? So I'm so grateful you're here to walk me through it because I have never used ChatGPT before, and I understand that it uses data from the internet to source its responses. But because your workshop isn't online, I think there's a little added layer of difficulty. So I'm interested to see how we can train the data to create a blog.
Absolutely. So for most people, there are two ways to interface with the technology, the playground and the chat page, which we've all seen. If you want to get the most out of your prompts, you would use the playground because it has a set of options you can manipulate. The setup that I have here has our system message, which includes a transcript of the AI workshop. And then it has our user inputs that we're going to use to be able to ask questions and create the content that we want. Mm-hmm. So the first one that we have is, can you write a 500 word blog post on the key takeaways from this workshop? So simple as that, we're going to submit it. As we can see, it's already coming out with a lot of text, and I can see some of my own wording in there. So it's actually sourcing the information that we gave it here. We also noticed that it got cut off. We ran out of text here because we need to set our maximum length here, or tokens, up to a much higher number for our 500 word blog post. So the way that tokens work is that it's how OpenAI knows what to charge you. Mm-hmm. So around 4 characters is equal to 1 token. If you're on a fresh new account, you'll get a set allotment of money for a predetermined amount of time before you have to start paying for the tokens once that runs out. For this example, I'm actually going to pump it up all the way to the right. Oh, look, it's very polite as well. Absolutely.
Absolutely. Now, absolutely is longer than sure. Do we get charged more for using absolutely?
Yes.
Are you
absolutely
serious?
Yeah.
Okay.
So it looks like it's definitely sourcing a lot of information from this original transcript, but it's very repetitive here. So that brings us into our next variable that we can change, which is the temperature. Mm. So having a high temperature means it's going to take a lot more creative liberties.
What I learned from your workshop mm-hmm. is that the higher the temperature, the less confident it is, and it's more inaccurate.
Right. While I think that ChatGPT is really great for conversation and creating content, I think that you still need to do of your due diligence of doing the proofreading that it needs.
So if I wanted to have like the top 5 and I want to number them,
yep.
How can I prompt it to put it in that format?
Ask it like you just asked me. This model is trained on human language, and the way that we can best interface it with is by talking to it like a normal human being. So let's go back to the answer that it gave us. And while it was great, let's start messing around with the temperature to see if we can get some better responses. Mm-hmm. So I'm gonna delete this one, and I'm gonna go and I'm gonna put it all the way at the maximum. I'm gonna put it at a temperature of 1 and just see what kind of answer it gives us. I'm also going to make the changes that you said. What was it called again?
Listicle.
Listicle, like that?
Yeah.
Awesome. Oh, perfect, so there are the bullet points.
There we go.
Which is great.
You know what I would love to add to this mm-hmm. is an introduction and conclusion.
So let's do that. And let's not make even a new prompt, because the great part about ChatGPT is that you can continue to ask questions and it will reference the text, so not only the system text, but the previous text and its own answers.
So it can build off of itself.
Yep, absolutely.
Very
so
cool.
Can you also write an introduction? And there you go. And looks pretty close to the content of my slides as well. Wow, all right,
so
it's a lengthy one.
That's a giant paragraph.
That's a giant paragraph. Here we go. Can you make this shorter? Ah, sure, here's a shorter version. Wow,
way shorter.
Way shorter.
So we set out to write a blog to cover your workshop, right? And it couldn't pull information from the internet, so we fed it the text that it needed to pull from. Then with a little finagling, we got it to write a listicle with a short introduction and conclusion. Mm-hmm. And so next steps is that I will take this and review it and maybe massage the language a little.
So yeah, you want to be able to go through it, you want to be able to check it, and you also want to do it like add your own flavor to it, because it will come off as like a little bit robotic and maybe repetitive.
One of the things that I find interesting here is that it's not that ChatGPT is gonna replace my job, but it's more so a tool that we can use to elevate our work and to make our workflow more efficient.
Absolutely, 100%. At the end of the day, you're going to need somebody who knows what the output is, because if you don't, then it's gonna be pumping out information that might be incorrect or malicious or anything like that, or dangerous.
Excellent. So I'm thrilled to know that I will not be replaced by a robot anytime soon.